Hey, hi, hello, namaste, welcome to CRNT Designers, Chetan here. And in this tutorial, we are going to do simple and easy hard surface model. So anybody and everybody can understand it easily. So without wasting of time, now let's get started. To make this kind of model, you need to add a cube. And then go to the edit mode and then you need to add the loop cuts like this to two loop cuts at the center of that cube. Okay, along the x and y axis. Then you need to select this bottom faces and then use the loop tool to make a circle. Okay, and then you need to scale it down a little bit and then move it along the z axis. Easily you can do this. The first and foremost thing we are going to do, which is the block out. Okay, then you need to move extrude it one more time and move it along the z axis. And go to a little bit back and then scale down it along the x and y axis. And now just need to adjust its height so you can make it proper. Okay, then press I for the insert operation and then adjust the scale a little bit and extrude it one more time and then scale it one more time, scale down it a little bit because we want to create that conical shape at there. So that's why you need to do the same steps, like press I for the insert operation and then you need to extrude it along the z axis and scale it down a little bit to maintain that conical shape. Okay, after that you need to do this step one more time to get the right kind of shape and then just create a taper kind of shape at there. That's fine. And just you need to adjust the size of your mesh a little bit and then select these faces and then you need to extrude them along the z axis and just move it a little bit along the z axis and that's look decent. And now you need to add more loop skirts because we are going to use the subdivision surface modeling method. So that's why you need to add the loop skirts like this. So that's why you can use the insert operation because there is not any kind of large taper kind of shape. So you can use the insert operation to improve your speed. Otherwise, you can add the loop skirts with the loop cut tool, like press Ctrl R and then add the loop skirts. That's also one way. And this is also. And just add the more loops with the help of insert operation also. You can do that. And then add a loop cuts like this and now that's look good. So select these faces and press I for the insert operation and create a one loop at there. And now that's look good, decent. So we have done the first thing, which is the block out. Just adjust the proportions and that's important. Then we are going to move toward the next step, which is adding the more details on it. So that's why you need to add the loop cuts on your mesh. And because you need to know which kind of design you want to create on it, and that according to that you need to add the loop cuts, you need to create a geo on it. So just I have selected those loop cuts and I have added the bevel on it. So just use the bevel tool for that. Okay, and then give the proper width. Then you need to use the extrude along the normal operation, like extrude operation. And then just add one more time insert operation. And then extrude it out a little bit. And that's look good. And after that, you can scale it down along the Z axis individually. Make sure your individual scale should be on. Okay, then just need to scale it down a little bit along the Z axis. You can find out that individual origin along beside that global transform orientation. Okay, just scale it down a little bit and you need to adjust the proper scale according to your design. So that's also important thing. You should think about the minute things of your model so you will give the decent look to your model. Okay, that's after that you need to select these faces and press I for the insert operation because we are going to use the sub-D modeling method. So that's why we require the more loops at there, means more topology, more geo on our mesh. Okay, then you can add the subdivision surface modifier. Now you can see it's look good. Just we need to increase this level viewports and then shear smooth it. Right click and shear smooth it. And now it's look decent. Now we can move toward the next details, which is the secondary. So before that, just add loop cuts wherever it's necessary. And you can try and see where the loop cuts look good or where not. According to that, you can add more loop cuts if you want, and otherwise you can keep it as it is. So here just I want to create a little bit of design, so just press I for the insert operation, select those faces and use the insert operation, and then scale it down and then use the extrude along the normal, that's it. And then press I for one, just scale it down a little bit and just adjust its depth with the help of move tool, which is a transform orientation tool, and then press I for the insert operation, and then add necessary loop cuts supportive edges at that particular part on your mesh, so you can maintain the form of the model. That's it. And then press I for one more time for the insert operation, and that's look good, decent. After that, you need to move toward the secondary details on your model. So you need to think about it. So just duplicate it just for the backup. Keep the backup collection always, and then apply that subdivision surface modifier one time with the one level viewports, and just try to figure out which kind of secondary details you can add on your model. So here I'm trying that it will look good. So you need to think about it. If it's look good, where you need to add more geo, just when you will add details like this, so you can understand. So here this kind of design will look good, so I can go for this design. So that's why I have created those backup collection, because if I go toward the more details, so I can't come back. So just that's why here I can come back, because that's those were not more details. So just I have selected here faces, four faces, and then use the insert operation, scale it down a little bit, and use the loop tool to make a circle. And after that, you need to press I for the insert operation one more time, just to add one more loop cut out there, and then you need to extrude it along the normal extruding side a little bit, and give the proper extrude operation, proper extrude like a width at there, and just you need to scale it down a little bit. And just here I'm trying to figure out the right width for the insert or extrude operation. And you can see the hard surface modeling, we need to maintain the details with the right topology also. And design is the thing where you need to do trial and error based method. According to that, some designs will look good or some not. So you need to see which will look good and with which we can go ahead. So that's also important thing. Okay, and that's look good. And don't make it too complex things. So just here I'm going to select these faces because I want to add more details at here. Because it's a simple modeling tutorial, so we won't go for the more complex. Just select these faces. And then you need to press I for the insert operation. Just hit I for the insert operation. And this design also I have tried before creating for the tutorial. And then I have decided that this will look good, so I can go for it. So such kind of several designs I try for this model. And then I selected these tools, and which I'm showing you right now. Okay, then you need to use the insert operation and press I for the insert operation. And then just you need to scale it down a little bit and create a simple design, and that will also look good. I always say you that don't need to make a too complex things, because if you are making a simple one, then those simple things also look good, which gives you decent look. So just I have added one more loop at there, and that's look good. So thanks for watching. If you like this tutorial, then hit that like button and subscribe my YouTube channel. Bye bye, see you in the next video. Take care.